are unique. We've often been told that if we stripped our skin off and stripped away our gender parts, that we'd all be the same, right? In the era that I was raised in, the era that I went to school in, we were in the attempt to create equality among races and genders, I think we were trained that we're all kind of the same. And this is really not true. The other thing about human bodies is we have the ability to self-regulate. So our bodies are self-regulating. Often if we go to the doctor, we would think, oh, our bodies have lost the ability to regulate themselves because we're told we need blood pressure medication or medication to regulate our insulin. Our bodies have the ability to self-regulate when treated properly. We are also whole. We're whole and we're integrated. Our systems are integrated. We're not a conglomeration of a circulatory system and a urinary tract and a brain, which is sort of separate from our body, but we are whole and we are integrated beings. The other thing about our human bodies is we are not, our health is not merely the absence of disease, but it's a true optimal function and a vitality. And that's what we should be looking for in our health. We shouldn't be settling for, okay, you did a bunch of blood tests, everything fell within the normal limits, you are healthy. But then the next time you go to the doctor, something doesn't fall in within the limits, oh no, you are diseased. When really we're a continuum of health, right? And we want to be on the optimal end. We don't want to settle for something that is kind of, right? We're not quite technically diseased, but things are not so great. You know, we don't have energy. We wake up tired. We feel exhausted at the end of a work day. We feel sick, you know, kind of, after we eat. We don't want to be like that. We want to be impressive, vital, optimal human beings, right? So the first thing I want to talk to you about is our uniqueness. Really, rather than just being a human body, we are an expression of our DNA, which is totally unique to us. And so even though we all have two eyes, a nose, and a mouth, there's not two of us in this room that really look alike. We're all very unique. And we recognize that about our faces because we can see that. Our insides of our bodies are like that as well. We are totally unique on the inside. We may have the same organs, but each one of those organs, each one of those parts has its own little idiosyncrasies. And not only that about our DNA, our DNA changes as we live. So we're kind of taught that we are born with this set of blueprints, right, that are what they are, and that they don't ever change within your life. Well, now we know that they do change, that we have something called epigenetics, and we get these little tags on our DNA that turn them on, that turn genes within our DNA on and off. So we could be coded, say, for a breast cancer gene, which may never express, or a quote-unquote breast cancer gene, that may never express itself because of the way that we are living and treating our bodies. Or we could be coded for something that does express because of the way we are living or treating our bodies. Not only does our DNA change throughout our life, some of that epigenetic material gets passed on to your children. So not only are you changing yourself, but you're also changing your kids. Many of the diseases we experience are caused by inflammation. So Alzheimer's is a great example. of a disease that we think of as being fairly untreatable. Once you get it, you're kind of stuck with it. The latest research shows that that's really not true. Not only is it treatable, but it may be quite reversible as well. And it has an awful lot to do with fat. So I brought some examples of some healthy fats for you guys to see. So olive oil. Olive oil is very good for us. It's full of antioxidants. So does anybody know what an oxidant is and what an antioxidant is? So we hear this all the time, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, it's an O negative ion in your bloodstream. Did I get it close?
So oxidants are electron stealers.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So they steal electrons. If they steal them from our DNA, that's really bad. It's bad to steal them from our cells in general, but to steal them from our DNA is really bad. Antioxidants are like little sacrificial lamps. So they will donate electrons to make up for oxidative stress. So because we are oxygen-breathing organisms, and because we live in a modern world, one of the things that we suffer from that causes disease is oxidative stress. So the stealing of electrons from our tissues. So if we can get some nice antioxidants, like olive oil, avocados, coffee, which many of us are drinking, right? Then we get some electrons donated to kind of make up for that oxidative stress. The other thing about functional medicine that I want to share with you is that we think of diseases as being concrete, right? As having, here's the disease, here's the treatment, it's always the same, right? And that's not true. One disease could have many different causes. And if we want a true cure, we've got to get to the bottom of that cause of disease. And that's one of the things, functional medicine is really advanced diagnostics that get to the root cause of disease. And correcting that imbalance, the side effect of correcting that imbalance, correcting that problem, is that the disease is cured. Right? So we can have positive side effects of our treatment instead of negative side effects. So thank you, fellow Toastmasters. Any questions?
Yeah.